Curzon Street number 3 viaduct is one of 5 connecting viaducts that make up the station approaches viaducts, starting at Duddeston Junction as HS2 comes into Birmingham city centre and ultimately terminating at Curzon Street Station. In our last update, we showed the construction of the first of the reinforced concrete in situ piers. You can see that video by following the link here. Since then, we've continued on with the piers and we've made great progress, completing 22 of the reinforced concrete V-shaped piers. And following the completion of the piers, we've made great headway with the deck construction. And we're here today because we've completed the first span on deck A of Curzon Street number 3 viaduct deck. And here's how we constructed the first section of the deck, which was deck A, grid lines 1 to 4. So the first thing that will strike you is the curved radii profiles that go from the wing to the soffit. That's just an architectural feature. So we're stood next to, I'm walking along deck A, but you can see deck B in the background. There's actually a gap in between them. They're separate decks, separate spines. So we've got spines A, B and C, all have 2 rails. Spine D has 1, so that's 7. So it's splaying out for the platforms, but it's also for the public realm side of it as well. The gaps in between the deck are to maximise the daylight in between the decks. Starting a couple of years ago now, we had 185 number large diameter auger piles installed. On top, once those were complete, we installed pile caps, 28 number pile caps for Curzon Street number 3 viaduct. Once the pile caps were complete, we cracked on with the V-shaped piers that you can see. So this is, I'm stood next to 1A, you can see 2A and 3A in the background, 22 number of them in total for Curzon 3. And then once all that was complete and signed off, we then began with some of the enabling temporary works for the deck. So you can see here, the vast hard-standing slab was installed as a nice clean working platform and a foundation for the load bearing falsework and formwork, which you can also see behind me. The falsework is the metallic structure, looks a bit like scaffolding, it's actually load bearing falsework, and on top of that you can see in the background some of the orange beams there, that's the formwork to actually form the deck. All that was done, completed, signed off, everyone happy, and then we go up there ready to start fixing the permanent works. So I'm now stood opposite Pier 1A at the end of Curzon Street number 3 deck A. That's actually the end, grid line 1 is the end of Balfour Beatty Vinci's work on the deck. I'm also stood next to our neighbours, Mace Dragados, who are going to be constructing the interconnecting bit of viaduct in between grid line 1 and the Birmingham Future City Centre Station, Curzon Street, the terminus of HS2 in Birmingham. So far we have completed on deck A, we've completed 3 sections of the deck. Deck A, grid lines 1 to 4. Deck B, grid lines 1 to 4. Deck C, grid lines 1 to just past 3. For what we've poured so far, so that's A, B and C, 3 sections, we've poured over 2,500 cubic metres of concrete so far. So we've just walked a bit further down the path, a bit further along, so we're now stood in between sort of decks B and C. We are onto the parapet installation on deck B, the next phase of the works after the main pour of the deck, as part of the finishing works. So the tower crane is just about to offload one of the parapets and it will take it up onto deck B and it'll be installed on the side of the viaduct. So we're now stood at the foot of Pier 1A by the stair towers up to the deck. We're going to go up and have a look and see what's going on up there. We had to complete the previous permanent works, that's the piled foundations, the pile caps and the reinforced concrete piers. Once all that was completed, we were then in a position where we could actually begin with the deck permanent works. That is the reinforcement, and we also have polystyrene void formers and post-tensioning ducts, because it's a post-tensioned reinforced concrete viaduct. So for the reinforcement, a lot of the reinforcement was prefabricated away from the deck and lifted onto the deck as a more efficient and safer means, reducing operatives' manual handling and the number of lifts of bundles of rebar to then be picked up and fixed in situ. And then came pour day. We poured the first pour on deck A, so grid line 1 to 3.5. That was over 700 cubic metres of concrete. Pour started at 2 a.m. in the morning to minimise the disruption to the local roads. We were here with three big concrete pumps, 65 metre concrete pumps, discharging the concrete, self-compacting concrete into the deck, finished it off, wait for it to gain strength, completed the post-tensioning. Once the post-tensioning was complete, the deck had sufficient strength and we could start removing the formwork and false work and let the deck just support itself. What happens next is we rinse and repeat and continue doing what we've done on grid lines 1 to 4 for the subsequent sections. So we've now reached grid lines 5 and 6. This is where the deck starts to taper in. You might just about be able to see behind me the falsework and formwork installation. We're shortly about to commence the reinforcement installation, but it's the repeat process of what we've done on grid line 1 to 4. And then we continue doing that until completion. Yeah, it's a nice feeling, especially since we completed the first section of the decks and have removed the falsework and formwork, and you can see the permanent structure there exposed as it's going to be for years to come. That was a very rewarding moment. If there's anything else you'd like to know about the Birmingham Approach Viaducts, be sure to let us know in the comments below. Thanks for watching.